Karen, here's a chance to share one of Mom's secret recipes. Karen is here from Stownut Donut and Diner, where we have some good times when we go to your place. We have a good time when you come
yeah.
here. I love that place. So are all the people sitting around the counter right now watching?
Oh, they're all watching. They're all watching.
What street is that on?
That's Fish Creek and Graham.
Okay, Stownut Donut and Diner. When I remember when I was there visiting, it was hard for me to say the name because it's sort of tricky. So you're going to make noodles.
I'm going to make noodles.
And how do we do this?
And they're really easy to make. All I have it right now is that one egg, some salt, and this is about 5 tablespoons of water. And you just want to beat that up.
So now tell me about where the secret came from.
My mom made noodles for everything. Mm-hmm. I mean, no matter what she made soup for Thanksgiving, after Thanksgiving dinner, mm-hmm. she made turkey noodle soup.
Now, when she made her noodles, did she roll them out on the table and cut them with a knife?
Roll them down, yeah, and left them sitting on the table so you can watch them dry.
Oh, that's right. So did she put them on cloth then?
She left them just on the table,
uh-huh.
sprawled out everywhere. So we made the noodles.
Uh-huh.
I made some earlier.
So that's so you'd put this out here and you'd roll it out with the pin,
yes.
So it'd be flat.
Right. Now, the best thing about homemade noodles is you can make them as thick and as thin as you want.
Mm-hmm.
Some people like them really thin, some people like them really thick.
May I grab your noodle?
Yes, you may grab my noodle.
There you go. There we see. Oh, yeah, this is really cool.
So
they're sort of thick.
Right. My father always liked them thick, so I roll them real thick.
So do you have to cook these then before you put them in this?
Cook them in the water that I just boiled, pulled uh-huh. them out, and threw them in the dish.
So how long would you cook them in the boiled water?
It takes about 5 minutes to cook, because you don't want to overcook them.
Yeah, they're a little al dente.
Mm-hmm.
It tastes good. They got a little salt in them, huh?
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. You have to add the salt to the, and all it is egg, salt, and flour.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is for tuna noodle casserole. I have one can of mushroom soup, one can of tuna. Now, if you like more tuna, you can add another can of tuna.
Mm-hmm.
And then about a half a cup of milk. And then I just stirred that in.
How many kids grew up eating tuna noodle casserole one night a week, huh?
I'll tell you, I loved my mom's tuna noodle casserole. And I never knew why until I called her to ask her what was on her top.
Do you think it's still as popular now?
I did. I asked a lot of my customers, and they said they do. They like the yeah. tuna noodle casserole, and so they were excited.
I wonder if the kids do, because my kids always go, no.
Now, what my mom did is, what my favorite part was the crunchy part mm-hmm. on top of the tuna noodle casserole. And all she said was she melted some butter, stirred the breadcrumbs in it, and
so she puts the crunch in it first, then.
Right, and the thyme, where's my thyme?
What time is it?
I don't know what. Oh, there's it.
There it is.
And she put just a little bit of thyme.
That's
in.
A little bit. That'll make it crunchy.
Thyme flies.
Thyme flies.
So this is, just mix it up. Thyme has got a lemony flavor for fish.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why it's really good. And you just add it to the, but this was my favorite part of the tuna noodle casserole.
It gets a little crispy top.
Right.
And you know, it's nice to make it sort of neat, but people worry about making it perfect. It sort of cooks itself perfect.
Oh, yeah, yeah, you don't have to worry about it. This is about the easiest
mm-hmm.
one to make. Now, I also took the noodles and made
the noodles
chicken,
are great, by the way.
Chicken noodle soup. This is really easy.
Now, this chicken noodle soup has great color, huh? Look at that.
And there we go.
This is not that chicken soup out of a can, is it?
No, this is...
I had a feeling.
This is what I serve at the diner. You just take the noodles, cook the noodles.
You transformed a donut shop into something spectacular, I'll tell you that.
It's mom's place, basically. But I just...
what
I
do
is you have to make sure the water is boiling when you make the noodles. Otherwise, you're going to have a slimy noodle. But you boil the... I like to boil my broth.
Mm-hmm.
Boil my broth in and throw the noodles in. Then I cut up chicken and add the chicken, onions, and I have a chicken base.
You poach the chicken first?
I try to cook it in the pan mm-hmm. for the flavoring.
Like in the broth?
Right, right.
Yeah, that's a good idea. I love that.
And you try to do is one pan everything.
Mm-hmm.
But
this is great. Let me try this little soup here, huh? It's fantastic.
Well, thank you.
Yeah. That's a big thing in my house, too. Everyone's like, how's the chicken soup this year? You know,
it's not a hard thing to do. Everybody can get it done within seconds.
Great. This recipe is going to be on the website?
Yes, it is. Yeah.
The noodle secret is out.
Yes.
Okay, folks. That's Stownut Donut and Diner.
Right.
In Stone. There you
right.
go. Okay. Hey, when you wait.